Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how you can install Gogs on a Linux server. But before we do that, let's first take a look at what Gogs really is. Gogs is a self-hosted Git service, and you can compare that to running your own private GitHub installation. Gogs is written in Go, and it's also very lightweight. In fact, it is so lightweight that it can run on a Raspberry Pi. So if you have a Pi laying around at home, you can use that as your own Git server. So what do you need for this tutorial? Well, first of all, you're going to need a DigitalOcean account because I'm going to install Gogs on a DigitalOcean droplet. You're going to need an SSH client to communicate with that droplet. And so for Windows, you can use PuTTY, or for OS X, you can use the built-in terminal. And that's what I'm going to do. So what's next in this tutorial? Well, first I'm going to create a new droplet on DigitalOcean. I'm going to download Gogs to that droplet, and I'm going to run through the initial configuration. So let's begin. Okay, so we're going to start by creating a new droplet on DigitalOcean. So I'm going to go to the administration console, which is cloud.digitalocean.com, and I'm going to click on droplet. And once this is finished loading, there we go. I'm going to choose to use the Ubuntu server image because I'm most familiar with Ubuntu server, but you can choose Fedora, Debian, you can use any Linux distribution that you like. And here I'm going to leave the default version to 1404. This is the LTS version, that's fine by me. And for the size, I'm going to actually pick the smallest size, not only because it's cheapest, but also because half a gig of memory is more than enough to run Gogs on. Next, I'm going to pick a data center region. I'm going to pick Amsterdam because that's closest to where I live, and so that should improve the performance of the network to the server. I'm going to add my SSH key here so that I don't have to use a password. SSH keys are a lot safer to use. I'm going to say one droplet. I'm going to leave the default host name like this, and I'm going to click create to finally create and provision the Linux server on DigitalOcean. So there we go. DigitalOcean is now provisioning our VPS, and we'll be able to install Gogs on it in just a minute. Okay, so after a couple of minutes, DigitalOcean finished creating my droplet, and here it is. So right now we're going to log into the server. So I'm going to click on the IP address here. I'm going to copy it, and I'm going to go to my terminal. I'm going to say ssh root at, and then the IP address of my droplet to log into my droplet. I'm going to type enter, and now my Mac is asking me, hey, can I trust this server? So I'm going to say yes, you can, and boom. We're logged into the server. I didn't have to type a password because I chose to use an SSH key to log into my server. So that's great. So one of the first things that you want to do when you created a new Linux server is to run updates. So I'm going to say sudo apt-get update. And this is going to update the list of packages. And after that, I'm going to run sudo apt-get upgrade to upgrade all the packages installed on the system. So let's do sudo apt-get upgrade. Let's hit enter. Now I'm gonna say yes. It's gonna update all these packages. And so in a few minutes, my VPS will be completely up to date. Okay, so all our updates are installed. So the first dependency that Gogs has is, of course, Git. It needs Git to function and to be able to look at the contents of your repositories. So I'm gonna say apt-get install git to install the Git client. I'm going to say yes. And once more, it's going to download a lot of packages, unpack them, and install them. There we go. It's done. So with Git installed, we're ready to actually download Gogs. So to do this, go to the Gogs website, which is gogs.io, and look for the downloads page, and then look for install from binary. And here you'll find the download links to a variety of binaries for different platforms. And we're interested in the Linux binary for either 386 if you have a 32-bit server, or AMD64 if you have a 64-bit server. Now, I created the 64-bit droplet, so I'm going to go for AMD64. And I'm going to copy the link to the tar.gz archive. So now I'm going to go to the server, and I'm going to type in wget and then the URL of the archive to actually download the archive. And when that's finished, I'm going to unpack the archive. I'm going to type in tar xvf and then gogs, and I hit tab for autocomplete. I hit enter. So once Gogs is unpacked, let's change directory to Gogs and let's see if it runs. We're going to type in /gogs, type in web, hit enter, and there you go. Gogs is up and running on our server, so let's check it out in the browser. So in my browser, I'm going to navigate to the IP address of my droplet, and I'm going to go to the port 3000 to access Gogs. And I'm immediately greeted by the installation process of Gogs, and it asks me to configure my database. I'm going to pick SQLite because it's very tiny and very lightweight. I don't have my MySQL installed on the server. I'm going to give it a name. I'm going to call it Xavier's Git Hosting. And I'm going to leave pretty much all the rest left to the default settings. This is where all repositories will be stored. This is the user as which Gogs will run. And now because I ran Gogs as root on my server, I have to type in the root user here. Now, be careful with this. This is actually not recommended to run Gogs as the root user of your server. It's never recommended to run anything as root. So if you want to deploy Gogs in a real world environment, make sure you create a new user to run Gogs off. So the only thing I'm going to change right now is the domain name. Right now it's set to localhost, but this obviously has to become my domain name, or in my case, just the IP address of my droplet, because I didn't connect a domain name to my droplet. I'm going to leave the SSH port, the HTTP port left to default, and the application URL, I'm going to change that as well. I'm going to type in my IP address instead of localhost. Now the only thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create the first user in Gogs. I'm going to go here to admin account settings, and I'm going to create the first user in Gogs, which is the administrator. So I'm going to call him Xavier. I'm going to type in my password. I'm going to type in my email address. And that's it. The setup process of Gogs is done. All that's left is click install Gogs and wait for it to perform its magic. And here we are on our freshly installed Gogs server. It's all set up, it's all working. We can start creating Git repositories and we can start collaborating on great software. Now before we do that, there's just one more issue left. If I go back to my server here, I can see the output of the Gogs process. And if I type Control C to stop Gogs and I go back to my browser and I hit refresh, all of a sudden I can't access my Gogs installation anymore. And that's because Control C has stopped the Gogs process. So the final thing that we have to do is to run Gogs and to make sure that it keeps running in the background. And to do this, we're going to go back to our server and we're going to run Gogs again, but then this time in the background. And so I'm going to run Gogs by typing /gogs web, just like we did before. But now I'm going to append this ampersand and I'm going to hit enter. And now Gogs will run in the background. Again, I can view its process, but if I now type control C, and if I type exit to quit the console and I go back to the browser, I'm still able to access Gogs. So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one.